Are we on the air?
Yes, you are.
Yeah, the new Flow 93.5. It's OTA Live. No Boogeyman tonight on the show.
Oh.
I know, right? He's taking a break tonight. But big shouts to the Boogeyman with the burn. Tonight, OTA Talk Special Edition 2010 Wrap-Up. All right, big shouts to Footage in the building, making us look pretty on camera like he always does. And we got a crazy, like, round table of guests right now.
Great lineup. Yeah. We go ladies first because that's how we do it.
Oh, yeah,
We have some brought up teams, my mom would say.
Oh, yeah.
Founder of the blog site ilovelola.net and all round media savvy lady, Lola is in the building. How you doing?
I'm doing well. Thank you. How are you?
I am good. From the Real Frequency Show on the Midday Mix and doing his thing right now on his laptop, like most DJs do, which is multitask. DJ P Plus in the building.
Yep.
Yep. And DJ Manifest from the Morning Live. And TML would be the acronym. CHRY and all around dude that is just as passionate about the local scene as we are.
Yes, sir.
You good?
Oh, yeah, we're good.
And finally, this dude, T-Rex, One Love T.O., that guy, that dude, craziest bunch of promoters putting things down in the city.
Now?
You want to give a quick rundown of the parties you guys do? Nostalgia.
Shuffle. Tribute. The private party series where only the sexy are invited. Out of mercy.
Okay, so it's a 2010 wrap up. We got a bunch of categories that we're going to kind of run through. Mm-hmm. And we do this every year.
Yeah.
So people that are familiar with the show for the last 5 years know what we do. And we're starting off with Song of the Year.
Oh, we're going right into the categories?
We're going right into the categories and then we're going to sort of just talk around that whole idea. So we're
all
starting
right.
Ladies first, and we could do it all the way throughout the night. Lola, your opinion, Song of the Year.
Okay.
Now, hold on. Now, Lola was like, came mad prepared, though.
No.
Oh, yeah. You could tell.
Wait, I'm the guy.
And don't worry, everyone's going to be pulling out their Blackberries for their
It's drizzy season right now. We are all pulling out the Blackberries, and that's how we're doing it.
Yeah. Well, personally, for Song of the Year, the song that I like listen to all
Two
year
hands.
Long with
No Hands.
Well, that one. Actually, I have three. Can I mention all three?
Sure.
I have Black and Yellow.
Okay.
I mean, I know it's a little late, but it's like one of my favorite records. No Hands, obviously. I've been cranking that all year long.
For the people that out there that may not know exactly who the artist is.
Okay, so Wiz Khalifa, Black and Yellow.
Right.
Waka Flocka Flame, No Hands, featuring Wale and Roscoe Dash.
Mm-hmm.
And I'd say Chris Brown and Tyga, Deuces.
Mm. Okay. Ooh. Okay. Okay.
So those have been my three like most played songs of the year.
All okay. Right. T-Rex?
Song of the Year. Man. I wasn't prepared, but I'm going to go with Paris Morton Music. I love the lyrics on that. Remember hearing that live for the first time and just being like, woo.
And of course, we're talking about Drake's
Paris Morton Music. It actually didn't make the Teflon Don album in time, but definitely made its impact. So
right.
I'm going to go with that.
Okay. Yeah. Manifest.
Thought about it, man. My mind always goes all over the place as a DJ, but I guess the one that stuck with me was Runaway.
Okay.
Kanye West. Anytime you can squeeze Douchebag and have the whole world singing Douchebag, that's
for sure, man.
Good point.
Pow.
Pete.
BMF Rick Ross.
Ooh. BMF Rick Ross.
That's a good one.
Okay. He's a DJ, though, so.
Ty.
No, I'm the one introing, so you go next.
I gotta go soft, man. Alicia Keys, Unthinkable.
Wow.
Yeah.
That is the song of the year. Sorry, you guys are all wrong.
For me, honestly, I got to go over. Only because I saw what that song did.
Mm-hmm.
And I saw not only that, you and me had conversations with that song in terms of when we first heard it.
Yeah.
And, you know, being dudes that have been in the industry for as long as we have, you automatically put your instinctive industry critique on. You're like, that's the first song you're going to go with, man?
Yeah.
And then,
I know, right. And then we were listening to it, and we're like, man, something sounds kind of, something ain't right or something's
awkward. But then Drake had that, listening party.
Yeah.
And he stood up there and explained and spoke exactly what we were talking about.
Right.
Exactly what we were feeling.
Right.
And he said even though he had those same feelings, he wanted to go with a song that was going to build and grow on people.
Right.
And if he could do that with authority and actually believe, have the confidence that the song would do that,
yeah.
For me, that's like, That's crazy.
And yeah, he was definitely right in saying that it was a song that was gonna grow on you. And
yeah,
it grew on me like crazy.
Like crazy, man. For you guys, how hard or easy is it for you guys to like come up with these ideas, best song, favorite songs of the year? Anyone, take that.
I mean, I think being a DJ, you just kind of know. I think one of the amazing things about being a DJ who's really in tune with music is like, there's nothing more amazing than picking a song. You're like, yo, this song's gonna pop, and then it pops. And it didn't pop because you seen hands in the air at the clubs, because you really felt it. So I think you kind of memorize that feeling and you go with it.
But has the digital era made it harder for you to come to those final decisions at the end of the year, given the sheer amount of music that
we
get?
Yeah, because it's saturation, so there's more music.
Do you think that makes it harder for us to actually give some songs the kind of chances that they deserve?
No, I just think it makes it harder for songs to be timeless and have a longer shelf life.
So you're saying that, you know, we get more music, but the chances of us having timeless records have sort of decreased?
Yeah, for sure.
Okay. Keeping it moving. Let's go with, and we're going to the furthest extreme now. We had like the best song. This is the song that, in your opinion, okay, it's a song that was, in your opinion, horrible, and yet still got a lot of love.
Like, anything like Ludacris.
But wait, was it horrible, like really bad horrible, or like
really
bad horrible?
A song that you can acknowledge as an industry person got like a lot of love. It was a huge song, but in your opinion, just like what? Like WTF? Like, you know what I mean? Like, start with you, Lola.
That's horrible, because I can't think of. There's not really too many that I can think of that I didn't like that got a lot of love. I mean, if you think of a person, like I know Waka Flocka didn't get a lot of love throughout the year. Like, people were dissing him in all corners. But I love him as an artist, because I've seen him perform live, and to me, you know, creating a feeling in people is what, you know, what makes an artist. So for artists, yeah. For song, I don't really have too many. Like, I guess the Gucci and Swizz Beatz Gucci Time, I wasn't really feeling that record, and it got a decent amount of love, but it wasn't like crazy love.
Right.
Okay.
And
okay.
It's not a crazy whack record either, but it just, yeah.
T, right. Cool. You can say it again.
Anything from Ludacris. Pow, 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 pow.
Really? Like anything from Ludacris that came out?
Period.
Really?
Ow, pow,
Get Low?
Pow.
Get Low?
Pow, pow, pow.
Really? Produced by a local.
Pow, 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 pow.
Okay, you got to give us more. Like, why do you feel that way about what he put out this year?
I mean, for me, it's like what we've seen music do. What we're witnessing right now with music is just a shift. People absorbing and embracing different things and adding, implementing, incorporating different things into their music. And I just feel like he just sounds the exact same he did in 2004 or whenever.
Right.
And it's like, it's annoying at this point.
So you think that his he, like, because I hear what you're saying, but I mean, a lot of artists usually have a signature.
No, that's cool. Oh. Signature. You know what I'm saying? You got to have your structure. You got to run your talent through a machine, but at the same time, you still got to be able to entertain. Like she said, Waka Flocka. Like, I put on Twitter just now, I said, look, what's the worst song? What's the worst song of 2010? I got tons of responses. But, you know, there's a couple people saying anything from Waka Flocka, anything from Soulja Boy. No disrespect, and I don't want you to unfollow me, but I can't agree with that, because at the end of the day, Soulja Boy, you play Soulja Boy, people are going to dance, they're going to have fun, they're going to laugh. And I'm T-Rex, I'm Toronto's party animal. It's all about having a good time, laughing, dancing, singing. So if Soulja Boy is providing the songs that do that, I can't hate on dude.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right, right, right.
So... it's kind of become of an age-old argument where it's like, well, you know, it's not real hip-hop and it's not this, da-da-da. Well, you know, there's different types of hip-hop for different times of the day, different times of the night, different settings. So, I don't know. I'm just going to go with anything from Ludacris. Pow, 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 pow.